We want to determine the derivative of the following function using the power rule, which tells us that the derivative of x to the power of n is equal to n times x to the power of n minus 1. So this crazy function is a nice review of some of the strategies that we use in order to apply the power rule to find the derivative of a function. So we'll first rewrite this function so that we can apply the power rule to each term. So we have f of x is equal to, we might want to rewrite this first term as 1/5 x to the 3/2. And then for the second term, we need to rewrite the cube root of x in rational exponent form. Remember, this x has an exponent of 1, so this would be 4 all over x to the 1/3 power. But then to apply the power rule, we want this to be up in the numerator. So if we move this up to the numerator, we're going to have 4x to the power of negative 1/3. So that'll be our second term, plus 4x to the negative 1/3 power. And then we can leave the last two terms the way they are. So we have 7x squared and then minus 9. And now we can find the derivative of each term. The derivative of 1/5 x to the 3/2 is going to be 1/5 times the derivative of x to the 3/2. So we'll multiply by the exponent. And the new exponent will be 3/2 minus 1. Plus the derivative of 4x to the negative 1/3 will be 4 times the derivative of x to the negative 1/3. So again, we're going to multiply by the exponent, and then we're going to subtract 1 to get the new exponent. So we'll have negative 1/3 minus 1, plus the next term will be 7 times the derivative of x to the second, which is 2 times x to the first power, minus the derivative of 9, but the derivative of any constant is 0. So we'll have minus 0. Now that we have the derivative, the rest is algebra. We need to simplify these terms. So the first term, multiply the fractions, we'll have 3/10 x to the 3/2 minus 1 is 1/2. Here we're going to have plus 4 times negative 1/3. So we'll write this as minus 4/3 x to the negative 4/3 plus, this will be 14x, and the last term is 0. Now let's go ahead and convert x to the 1/2 back to a radical, and the same here. So f prime of x is going to be equal to 3 square root x all over 10. Now for here, we're going to go ahead and move this down to the denominator and then write it as a radical. So we'll have minus 4. The 3 is still in the denominator. This will be x to the positive 4/3 power in the denominator. So the index would be 3, and we'd have x to the 4th plus 14x. Now we're almost there. Notice how we're taking the cube root of x to the 4th. So there's a perfect cube factor underneath here of x cubed. So we could simplify this cube root. Let's go ahead and do that before we stop. So f prime of x, it's equal to 3 square root x divided by 10 minus 4. And the 3 is here, and then because there's 3 factors of x underneath here, we'd have x times the cube root of x plus 14x. So this would be our final derivative. And just in case I lost you on simplifying this the cube root of x to the 4th contains a perfect cube factor right here, which simplifies to x cube root x. I hope you found this example helpful.